Hey friend, my name is Alan Lee and I help handymen all around the world take their businesses to the next level through day-to-day handyman business coaching. And today I wanted to talk specifically about how to determine what your pricing needs to be and how to make sure that you're actually making a good profit on each individual job. Now, I'm going to detail some awesome content for you here at the end of this video, so you're going to want to make sure that you stay tuned. At the end of the video, I'm going to get you guys the information that I would personally plug into 100% if I could go back just a few years ago. These are things that I wish that I would have known when I was first in business. But let's get started talking about pricing and how to figure out and make sure that we are pricing accordingly to what we actually need to make a profit. So let's go ahead and start by telling a story, okay? So back when I first started my handyman business, I just kind of pulled a number out of thin air for my pricing. I pulled out of thin air $50 an hour. I'm like, I'll charge 50 bucks an hour because I don't really know what other way to go. I had no other kind of coaching or information to tell me what my pricing should be. So I simply just did that. And I felt like, you know, at my previous job, I was making X amount of dollars per hour. Now I'm making $50 per hour, so I'm doing all right, right? I mean, that's the way that my mentality worked. So I would go out, do jobs for $50 an hour, felt like I was making a great dollar amount, and I just kept doing that until, at the end of the month, the bank account read almost zero. Now, that is probably the worst thing that you can do as a business owner, is just pull a number out of thin air and hope for the best, because that's really not how business goes. Now, I don't know if you guys are like that, but that's how my business was, is I had virtually no business skills whatsoever, and I didn't really know how to go about pricing handyman work or pricing jobs at all. All I knew about pricing and money was how much I got paid at my previous jobs and previous employers and things like that. So if you are in that same boat, you need this information, very, very important. The biggest thing that I did was I plugged into training. I plugged into business coaching. There's a lot of people out there that say, oh, I don't need anyone else to help me. But I'll tell you right now, this is not a problem that solves itself. This is a problem that you need to address, and you need to address it right now, or your business is never going to be profitable. I'll tell you that right now. So very, very important. You need to get plugged into business coaching if you are not already. Some sort, somewhere, somehow, you need to do that. At the end of this video, I will tell you a little bit more about the things that I would have specifically done, but with that, that's not something that's going to solve itself. So you need to take care of it. You need to address it right now. So one of the biggest things that I learned when I plugged into business coaching was that you need to track everything. The simple thought of what you track grows, and what you don't track does not grow. Okay, so it's as simple as that. Really, that's what it narrows down to, is tracking every single thing you do. So when you go out, and well, it starts before that. It starts with tracking your expenses, because that's the biggest thing. When you're talking about income and how much money you need per hour, you need to first think about expenses. How much are your expenses as a person, as a business? You need to tally those up, scour through your bank account, scour through your credit card bills, scour through your mortgage payments, scour through your medical bills, scour through all of these expenses, and figure out what your expenses are, and then what your income needs to be to match that and actually have a profit left over at the end of the month. So the conversation goes a few different ways. If you are a sole proprietor versus an LLC, S-Corp, things like that, and that gets a little bit more into you. I want to talk to a CPA when you get a little bit that far. But as a sole proprietor, the money that you make is your income. So you need to use your personal expenses as your expenses, and you take that, and I always multiply that number by 40%. And that's how I get what my dollars per hour need is. I call that my hourly need as a handyman, okay? So the need is what your expenses are. That's how much you need to be making per hour. So you take that, say that's per month, and then you figure out how many hours a month you traditionally work, and then you figure out what your hourly need needs to be. Multiply that by 40%, 20% for what I call a break-even number, and then 20% for profit. That gets a little bit more into, you know, the whole profit and loss, you know, outlook and things like that, which we'll talk about here at the end of this video. But very, very important to first establish what your hourly need needs to be so you can get your correct hourly rate. Once you figure that out, you need to track everything. Okay, so when you go out and replace the garbage disposal, track that. Okay, now this may sound very mundane, but you need to do this. I cannot guarantee that you're going to have the same results as me unless you do every single thing that I did. Okay, unless you follow every single step, I cannot guarantee that you're going to get the exact same results. The only way that you can get good results is by following directions. Okay, so you want to track everything. So track it, write down, how long did it take you to do that garbage disposal? How much did you charge? What was the client's thought like, right? Did they think you were a little bit on the high end? Did they think you were a little bit on the low end? These are all important things to figure out. You may not be able to ask the client directly these things, but these are things that you need to come up with intuition and try and figure that out the best you can. So track it so that the next time you do a garbage disposal, you'll be able to write down and be like, oh, on the last time I did this garbage disposal, I charged X amount of dollars and it took me X amount of time. How did that pan out? Did it take me longer than I thought? Did it take me more hours than what I estimated it for? Because if it did, then you need to adjust it on the next one. But see, if you never track that, you would never know that you need to adjust that number, because you'd be like, well, I think the last time I did a garbage disposal, I think I turned out all right, right? Like that's the thought. So you need to stop thinking and you need to start knowing. Now, there's this whole world of business growth and business development and tracking orders called KPIs, key performance indicators. One of the most important things that you can do for your business. And this is the simple, 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 down and dirty form of a KPI is tracking. How long did it take you to do that garbage disposal? How much did it cost? And then the next time you did it, how long did it take you? How much did it cost? The next time it did it, how long did it take you? You know, how much did you charge? And then soon you're gonna have five of those and you're gonna be able to come up with an average of what it costs and how long it takes to do a garbage disposal. So you're gonna very quickly figure out what your time frame is and what you need to charge for a specific job. You can still equate this to a big, large job like a bathroom remodel. Obviously, you're gonna have a bunch of different variables, you know, different size bathrooms and things like that, whether it was a shower or a tub or, you know, double vanity, single vanity, things like that. But these are all things that you need to make sure that you figure out. Now, again, like I said, I cannot guarantee that you will have these results unless you follow these examples. Start this today. Go home and start tracking. Think about the jobs you did today. Think about the jobs you did yesterday. Think about the jobs you did last week. Just start tracking them. Simple. Don't get overwhelmed. Just start tracking what you have and figure out what your hourly needs to be. Okay, now let's talk about the thing that I would do if I could go back in time and get a jump start on my business. Now, what we do as a handyman business consultant is we help handyman businesses all around the world take their businesses to the next level. Right now, we are engaged in a business builders private group. And this group is made up of tons of people that are focused on business growth. Now, if I could go back, I would plug into that specifically, because when I first hired a business coach, it wasn't handyman specific, it wasn't construction specific, but it was all about all business, which was great. But having a strictly construction rated business coach would have saved me years off of my life, off of my business's life. So for a limited time, I am offering 5 slots in our business builders program for 50% off. There's only 5 of them, and then after that, it's gonna be full price. I will put a link in the description below where you can find that if you are interested. Also, I will put a link in the description below to my Calendly where you can book a 15-minute call with me personally. If you have any more questions in regards to this or business building in general, I would absolutely love to hear it. So check out that comment section, leave me a comment with what your thoughts were on this video, and have a fantastic day.